Well, it is a new year, the time to rethink everything, including what we eat. Now, it is our tradition to have nutritionist Alyssa Bauman of nourished.ca help us get started for a new year. Alyssa, so good to see you. Happy New Year.
Thank you. You too.
I love the greens that you brought in today. So when we're talking about a move toward a more plant-based diet, what exactly do you mean by that?
I mean just trying to incorporate more fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, and whole grains into our diet. Not saying cut the meat out completely. I'm just saying let's move towards eating more plants.
All right. Well, let's give us an example of
example. So this is a classic, you know, looks like a burger, but this is a plant-based burger. So this is about 2 cups of quinoa and 2 cups of black beans mashed. And then I just put some onions, some oregano, and made them into little patties. And there you go. They're quite tasty. They have a meaty consistency.
Yes.
And you have your whole grains and you're getting your protein from your beans and your quinoa. And this is kind of how a plate should look. So right now we should be eating about half our plate should be vegetables, whatever vegetable you want that to be. I love kale, so the kale is here.
I love kale too.
And the other quarter should be whole grains like a quinoa and some kind of plant-based protein, in this case, a black bean.
Black bean, another plant-based protein.
Edamame. I mean, right here in this dish alone, there's about 2 fists, you're getting about 14 grams of protein alone here. Wow. And just for a level, like the average size woman who is active, 5'3", 125 pounds, she needs about 43 grams of protein a day to keep her going.
I see.
So unless she's building, you know, a bodybuilder or something like that, but 43 grams, that's not that much. So this right here is 13, as you can see.
It's more than a quarter of your daily.
Daily, exactly. And easy to snack on.
All right. Now, this is not rice. It looks a little bit
like
rice.
This is cauliflower rice. And what I love about the cauliflower rice is it's a really easy swap for meat. For instance, in a veggie lasagna like I have over there.
Oh,
so I used half turkey meat, okay, because I'm not saying forget the meat. And then I used half of this veggie rice.
And you still get a nice consistency.
You still get a nice consistency. You're getting your protein. You're getting everything you need. You're just kind of stretching the meat.
You don't miss that.
You don't miss it. And that's kind of what I mean here. It's like, you don't.
These kind of things. What's this?
Oh, this is like a veggie meat base. So this is made of cauliflower as well. They have broccoli. They have another couple other flavors. They're delicious and super easy to use too. And it has that meaty consistency.
It's just a little bit of a mindset
change.
Yes. Well, what is this? Is this the same thing that you use?
Okay. Now this is going
to
blow your mind. So this is on my website. This is a walnut taco filling. So instead of beef tacos, you put that inside your tacos
and
you put everything else that you want, your avocado, your salsa, and then that is your meat base. And that's walnuts. So healthy fats, your protein,
a nice little crunch to it too.
Crunchy and really surprisingly, right?
So I love that.
You know,
I love
that. We need to get creative.
Okay.
And that took 3 minutes in the Vitamix.
So you use the walnuts in there, but you brought in some other nuts as well.
Nuts and seeds, good source of protein and the healthy fats. And the healthy fats really is what we're looking for as well. So lentils, my favorite legume to use.
Mm-hmm.
This one has 14 grams per half cup. So if you look at this right here, that's about 2 cups. That is my entire day's worth of protein. So we live in such a protein-obsessed society. We think we need meat for protein. We have so many other sources and vegetables to get our protein from.
All right, what else have you brought?
This is quinoa. So quinoa is very high in protein as well, and this is a whole grain.
Mm-hmm.
Very easy to make things. Meatballs, you can substitute, quinoa with your meat, stretch your meat out by adding quinoa. So that's a great way too.
It's interesting you're talking about grains and whole grains and all of this at a time when a lot of people are saying, no grains, no carbs.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going keto, I'm going paleo, I'm
so there's these are the healthy carbs. So these are the carbs that aren't really going to put the pounds on us. Okay, these are the healthy carbs that have nutrients and we need to get going.
Okay.
We're talking about the carbs that don't really work for us,
the
Wonder Breads, the pastas, the muffins, the things that don't really have the nutrients. But these carbs and steel-cut oats and quinoa over here.
Tell me about these jars.
These are the carbs that we need.
These are
overnight oats, yes, with some quinoa.
You just soak them?
No, these are just soaked, and I made a big batch, and then I put them in these containers just so a grab and grow, and I just have to make them once. So this one is peanut butter, healthy fat, and a little bit of chocolate just to get that sweet.
Love that. This reminds me of your smoothies back. You've been talking about the smoothies.
This one is some cranberries and some pumpkin seeds. So again, we have those healthy fats and a little bit of sweetness from the cranberry. And this is your berries. So you're getting your antioxidants from your berries. And to add a little bit more protein, I love hemp seeds. I put it in everything. And some chia seeds to get your omega fats, and I put that in anything. You just sprinkle it on top and put this in your purse, and you've got breakfast to go.
Well, you've got breakfast to go, but let's just talk about that mind and body
you're nourished.
Combination you're as nourished. Well, and mm-hmm. how that leads to clarity and everything else when you're not bogging down your system with sugars and bad fats.
And the thing is that if you think about it in advance, and you have it on hand and you're prepared, you're feeding your body way, way better. So important to know how food affects our body.
I think I'm going to have a little bit more
I think
of this
you should, because it's really good for you, and it's going to keep you going. You had a long day.
You've got us off to a great start for a new year,
Alyssa.
Good.
I'm glad. Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.